Southern California. Saturday, August 12th, SoCal Pro Wrestling returns to the Vista Boys and Girls Club for Title Turmoil. The coveted SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship will be defended as the reigning champion Tommy Wilson defends against the Black Rose, Jew Diz. As a special stipulation to the match, the champion's manager Everett Scott will be handcuffed to the mighty Tortuga. The baddest man in SoCal Pro and reigning Golden State champion Tanner Black has issued an open challenge for his Golden State championship. Who will be the one to step up to this challenge and attempt to claim their place in history? All of this and more, including action from the neon phenomenon Anthony Idol, the SoCal Pro Wrestling powerhouse Matthias, Fidel, Bravo, and the high-flying legend SoCal Crazy. Tickets are available now at SoCalProWrestling.com. Southern California. Saturday, August 12th, SoCal Pro Wrestling returns to the Vista Boys and Girls Club for title turmoil. The coveted SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship will be defended as the reigning champion Tommy Wilson defends against the Black Rose, Jew Diz. As a special stipulation to the match, the champion's manager, Everett Scott, will be handcuffed to the mighty Tortuga. The baddest man in SoCal Pro and reigning Golden State champion, Tanner Black, has issued an open challenge for his Golden State championship. Who will be the one to step up to this challenge and attempt to claim their place in history? All of this and more, including action from the neon phenomenon, Anthony Idol, the SoCal Pro Wrestling powerhouse, Matthias, Fidel, Bravo, and the high-flying legend, SoCal Crazy. Tickets are available now at SoCalProWrestling.com. Southern California. Saturday, August 12th, SoCal Pro Wrestling returns to the Vista Boys and Girls Club for title turmoil. The coveted SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship will be defended as the reigning champion Tommy Wilson defends against the Black Rose, Jew Diz. As a special stipulation to the match, the champion's manager, Everett Scott, will be handcuffed to the mighty Tortuga. The baddest man in SoCal Pro and reigning Golden State champion, Tanner Black, has issued an open challenge for his Golden State championship. Who will be the one to step up to this challenge and attempt to claim their place in history? All of this and more, including action from the neon phenomenon, Anthony Idol, the SoCal Pro Wrestling powerhouse, Matthias, Fidel, Bravo, and the high-flying legend, SoCal Crazy. Tickets are available now at SoCalProWrestling.com.
Accompanied by his manager, the great Everett Scott, your SoCal Pro champion, Tommy Wilson.
My thoughts are that for the third time in a row, I am going to defeat Jew Diz right in this very ring. You all know that I am. Just like I defeated Anthony Idol at Storm Stadium, like I said that I would, to once again become SoCal Pro Champion. And for those of you idiots that missed it, I was waiting. Come on, clever people. What, right? You guys forgot your part. You want to play along? At least do it, idiots. I defeated Idol and am now a 7-time heavyweight champion. No one else is even close to that. I mean, the only guy that's even close is this man who's managed 6 guys to that championship.
I mean, as far as it's concerned, you might as well say Everett Scott is a 7-time heavyweight champion. And in the time that I've been here, I've made a lot of enemies. I'd say the biggest enemy I made would be Tommy Wilson. But after Death stepped on the door and tried to take Tommy out, and I was the only person from SoCal Pro to visit him in the hospital, we realized we're not so different. And we realized that with my brain and his brawn, we could bring the championship back home where it rightfully belongs, regardless of who faces us. Regardless, it could be anybody in the back.
I do leg day, but what are you doing out here, old man? You think you're gonna come out here and get me again? That ain't happening.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to SoCal Pro. I am your host, Rotten Ronnie Thrash, and I'm here with
Charlie Mulholland, making his commentary.
Charlie
debut.
Mulholland. And you know, we're here, we're doing commentary. Charlie, this is your first commentary gig, right?
Yeah, this is my first time, and this is my first ever match to call as Powerhouse Matthias takes on Anthony Idol. Now, why do you think Anthony Idol wanted to interrupt our SoCal Pro Wrestling Champion just before this?
You know, I'm gonna tell you exactly why, Charlie bit my finger, whatever your name is.
I have heard that before.
Anthony Idol actually beat Tommy Wilson at the last show. He beat Tommy Wilson, and he was champion for a matter of minutes before the next show up in Temecula at the Storm Arena. Tommy Wilson underhandedly beat him for the title to regain the SoCal Pro Heavyweight Champion. And Anthony Idol, to me, I think he's just a ball of rage tonight, and I feel bad for Matthias.
Yeah, I honestly say that Anthony Idol is in a bit of a ticked off mood tonight as he sends Matthias to the outside. And now a big shot right onto Matthias' forehead. Oh, and a chop! That kind of chop would have you wincing for days!
Did you hear that? Oh my God.
That took the wind out of my sails. I don't know how Matthias is feeling. The crowd are really behind Anthony Idol as they chant one more time. Is he going to give it to him? No, he just slams his head off the apron. Now, if you're Matthias and you take a shot like that, and
you mean like
another
that?
Shot like that,
you mean like that?
What do you need to do to get back into this match?
Run away, leave. I mean, you know, that's like getting hit with like a 50-pound bass. It just stings your chest, and I mean, you literally you cannot breathe. Speaking of cannot breathe, that's the hard way to come into the ring, baby.
Matthias has really not got started in this match yet, but now Anthony Idol with the Irish whip sends him into the ropes, and a big shoulder tackle by Idol as Matthias again retreats to the outside, and he calls for a timeout.
I don't think he's going to get a timeout here, Charlie.
I know, Ronnie, but at the end of the day, this is a one-on-one contest here at SoCal Pro Wrestling. Now, before this match, on Instagram, which is SoCal Pro, by the way, you can check us out on Instagram at
yes.
SoCal Pro. Matthias said that he wants to emulate Tommy Wilson in this match tonight against Idol and use whatever tactics he needs. Now, what do you think he means by that?
You know, why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you want to follow off what the champion's doing? I mean, he's the champion for a reason, right? And you know, Matthias has a lot to prove tonight. And you can tell that he's going to chop down the redwood that is Anthony Idol. And he's doing a great job so far. I mean, Matthias has done nothing but manhandle all of his opponents and just destroyed everyone that he's come into contact with.
Well, the clubbing shot to the back of Idol, and now he's got him in a side headlock. Knees to the stomach now. He's really got Idol up against the ropes here, and he's really trying to wear the veteran down. And a double underhook suplex from Matthias there.
You know how strong you got to be to do that?
He's got to really get those reps going in the gym to really toss around someone like Idol. Now shoots him into the corner, leg on the throat. That's got to be an underhook tactic, right? That's not fair.
And you know, the ref has got to get in there. He can't be afraid of these big dudes. He's got to get in there. He's got to keep it fair. Now you hear it. The crowd coming alive. Let's go, Idol. Let's go, Idol.
Let's go, Idol chants now reign here in Chula Vista as we are here for title turmoil. Don't forget tonight, we have the Golden State title on the line as Tanner Black takes on a mystery opponent.
Yes.
Who could that be tonight?
It could be me. We don't know.
Are you going to get in there tonight against Black?
You know, if it's for the title, you know, I may just come out of retirement, baby. Uh-oh.
Referee goes down one, and it's a count of one. Matthias looks a little bit frustrated. All that work, and he's only able to get a one count?
You know, Anthony Idol, I'm telling you, the man is a walking dump truck. Nothing stops him. Nothing.
Now here comes Matthias now. He looks like he's going to go for a knee to the back, and he's big backbreaker on Anthony Idol. I said earlier in this match that Idol just absolutely dominated the opening period, but now Matthias just seems to be on a roll. It doesn't look like Idol's going to get back into this match.
Absolutely, and you know, that's what Matthias has to do. He has to stay on Anthony Idol, because once you give Anthony Idol his win, just like that, you get slammed right to the mat, like so, and this could be it for Matthias.
Big spine buster, another referee calls a two and a no.
Wow.
Anthony Idol, the neon phenomenon with a beautiful spine buster, calls back to the likes of Arn Anderson with a spine buster like that.
Oh yeah, that was a beauty, man. And you know, I know Arn Anderson, Dusty Rhodes, a lot of those old school guys, you know, Anthony Idol really pulls a lot from them. So, you know, those moves hurt.
Now Matthias shoots him into the corner. Referee Chuck Finley now telling him to get out, so he sends it with an Irish whip into the corner again. Oh. Big impact as he smashes against the turnbuckle.
I thought the turnbuckle was free. I thought he hit the metal with how hard he hit. My goodness.
Now Matthias now stalking his prey as he reaches Idol back up with a shot to the gut and another one, sending him into the ropes. Looks like he's going to go for another Irish rip right now on Idol. Idol reverses. What's he going to do here? Big boot!
Wow.
Massive big boot there by the veteran Idol.
He's setting him up. He's setting him up, Charlie.
Now he drags him into the corner. He looks like he's going to be climbing the ropes. Here comes Anthony Idol, and he goes for a big splash.
My God.
Chuck Finley now goes down one, two, and no. Jesus H. Christ. This looks like it's going to be a big, big contest today.
I thought that was it. I mean, geez, I've seen Vader put away millions of people with that move.
The great big Van Vader, may he rest in peace. Now, here comes Idol. Oh, counter by Matthias, raking the eyes. Now, again, reminiscent of our champion, Tommy Wilson. You can see the inspiration.
That's what you gotta do, though. You gotta attack the guy's eyes. You have to attack the big man's legs, his eyes, all his vital organs.
Scoops up Idol now. Big power slam by Matthias, the powerhouse. And again, one, two, and no. Kick out again by Idol. What has it got to do to put away the veteran?
You know, it looks like Matthias is getting frustrated now. You know, he's starting to get a little sloppy. Now, just because he's getting sloppy doesn't mean that he's not going to power his way through. That's what he does in every match. So we'll see what he does here.
Oh, big, big offense now by Idol.
Uh-oh.
What's he gonna, he's dragged his arm into the rope and a big yank of the arm.
Man, that'll dislocate your shoulder quick.
Growing up in the likes of WCPW and PCW over in the UK, we've seen tactics like that used to manipulate the arm and really pull the tendons and joints to make your opponent, like a powerhouse like Matthias, not able to lift you up. And again, a big chop.
My goodness.
How many of those do you reckon you could take?
You know, I have taken chops like that from Anthony Idol, and I'm going to tell you, one is enough.
So if I offered you $20,000 to take a chop every time from Anthony Idol, how many are you taking?
Oh, absolutely. I'll have him give you 12. Yeah, that sounds great.
I think one in my, all the wind's coming out of my body now. Matthias shoots him into the corner. Big shoulder tackles in the corner. That's three. Referee calls him away.
And Matthias fixes his elbow pad, but you know what? I think Matthias has some big plans. Oh!
Side slam by Matthias.
Did you see the ring?
Two and no again. Chuck Finley calls the two count.
I thought the ring was going to break with that sidewalk slam. Jeez. Well,
that's the power of these two men, two big behemoths in the ring, and two elbow drops there from Matthias. He's looking to try and get him in the pinfall. One, two, and no.
Wow. You know, you're not going to be Anthony Idol with some elbow drops. You know, especially when you got little padded elbows. That's why he took off his elbow pad, because he realized he's got to hit him with the hard part of the elbow, baby.
The crowd now trying to renovate Idol to get back into this contest. Irish whip again by Matthias.
Oh, no, there
it is. And a spine buster of his own.
Oh, no, that's it. That could be it.
One, two, and the referee calls a two again. Matthias looks frustrated.
Matthias has put away everybody with that move. Everybody. The fact that Anthony Idol kicked out of it just shows that Matthias is moving up to the next level, and he's got to stay there.
What does he need to do to put away someone like Idol, a veteran in this industry, someone who really knows how to make a young comer like him work hard for that victory?
You know, if I were Matthias, I think at this point I would just knock out Chuck, knock out Anthony Idol, and go for the pinfall, hope another referee comes out.
Oh, the straps are coming down. Idol looks extremely ticked off with Matthias. Matthias pleading for his life.
Uh-oh.
What are you going to do now, kid?
Oh,
one,
no.
Two, three.
Oh,
and an elbow from Idol, reminiscent of the late Dusty Rhodes.
Yes, yes. Now he's toying with him. Now Anthony Idol is toying with Matthias. This is the beginning of the end, Charlie.
Now Idol trying to bring his opponent back into the ring. Looks like he's going for a suplex back into the ring. Lifts him up, just about.
Oh, wait a
minute. Matthias with a counter.
Wait a minute.
A crossbody counter. Wait a minute. What the hell?
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Matthias. What'd you think about that opening contest? Well, as you can see, Andy is out tonight, so I'm gonna be filling in his shoes. So, without further ado, let's keep this going, baby! We'll be right back.
Get out of here. It's my ring. I have to stay. Ladies and gentlemen, morons and stupid idiots out there. Now is the time for the greatest moment in this very night. Tanner Black's Golden State Championship Open Challenge. I've beaten everybody that stepped forward. Who could possibly challenge me? Send him out!
Ladies and gentlemen, his mystery opponent, he hails from San Diego, California, and is the certified badass, Rick Dallas!
We are back live at Title Turmoil here in Chula Vista with SoCal Pro Wrestling. Tanner Black has now had his mystery opponent revealed, and it's Rick Ellis.
Yes, Rick Ellis is a legend in Southern California. You Brits, you would know Rick Ellis, but I'm telling you, this man is dangerous.
Oh, I can't wait to see what he has in store for Tanner Black. Now, Tanner Black did say, boom. Big arm drag there by Ellis. And a drop kick as well by Ellis, really getting this match going quickly. Now, earlier today on Instagram, Tanner Black did say that going into this match, he did not care who his opponent was. Now right. That he sees Rick Ellis across the ring from him, does that change?
Oh, absolutely. So Rick Ellis, he holds so many titles in so many different indie promotions here in Southern California. And I'm telling you, when I say that he is a vicious little Wolverine, the man will tear you to shreds. And I think Tanner Black may have bitten off a little bit more than he can chew tonight.
Well, Tanner Black now, he's gonna face another chop by Ellis. Really trying to get the wind out of the sails of Black now. Now a headlock takeover and a big kick.
I think he's taller.
Here we go, and a running elbow.
Oh, wow.
From Ellis, really trying to get that crowd going. And now the referee calls 1-2. Just a quick two count.
You're not going to beat the champ like that.
No, definitely not. Now here comes Rick Ellis. Looks like he's going for a vertical suplex.
Oh,
snapping.
Wow. See how perfect that was?
Absolutely pinpoint accuracy by Rick Ellis. And now Tanner Black retreating. He's trying to run away from Ellis here on the outside.
Well, wouldn't you?
Oh, definitely. If I was going to take offense, like Ellis is giving, he's trying to cut him off in the ring, but big kick from Black, and now he's finally starting to get some offense going.
Now, that's what you got to do. You got to stay on a guy like Rick Ellis, because if you don't, I'm telling you, the man is a hurricane.
Ronnie, you've used some underhanded tactics in your time.
I have.
Oh, I don't want to be the one to say it, but that's the way it goes. What kind of offense does Tanner Black have to do to kind of cut off that momentum that Ellis has brought?
Well, Tanner Black, the first thing you got to do, and what I always say you got to do, is you got to take out the man's wind. Once you take the man's wind from him, then he can't breathe and he'll make mistakes. And that's when you can really capitalize. Now, Tanner Black is also the master of mind games. and he's going to play him here against Rick Ellis, and this is really going to play into his advantage.
Well, Black does like to run his mouth quite a fair bit, but sometimes you can run your mouth so much that you can cash a check that you can't really, you can't cash in. And now Black is just, oh, that's a classic.
Yeah,
classic show-off move.
But you say he can't cash a check. The man's the champion. He can cash all the checks he wants, even if they bounce, baby.
Well, he's definitely trying to hit that pedigree.
That's it.
He's going to go for one, two, three. And as quickly as that, it's over.
Ladies and gentlemen, your champion. Say. I declare another open challenge next month, September 9th at Super Clash. Be there!
Championship match, and that's the first of two, baby. What do you say? You want to keep this night going? Yes. You know what? Yeah, it is hot. Wait until you see. Wait until you see more wrestling action. It's gonna get even hotter, kid. The following contest, scheduled for one fall. Coming down to the ring from San Diego, California, SoCal Crazy! And his opponent from Bakersfield, California, he is the Young Dog, Romeo Caruso.
The time is finally mine. TKO, drop another dime. Not afraid to size or smash you in the face before you'll find a mize. Ain't no marks in the ring. It's all business. See the bling. Another running or dropping. They call him Romeo Cruz. And he stay keep it popping. Cause he stay poppin'. Keep it popping.
Keep it popping.
And he always steady popping.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And he always steady copping.
Yeah.
Everybody just dropping.
About to get it.
And you know he kept it popping.
We are back here, SoCal Pro Wrestling title turmoil here in Chula Vista, and now we have SoCal Crazy taking on Romeo Cruz.
Yes, Romeo Cruz, baby. I've never seen this guy wrestle before, so I'm actually kind of excited to see this match.
Both men shaking hands just before the ring. Now, on Instagram again today, Cruz did say that these two did fight 4 years ago when he was just a young kid. And he's come along a long way since they last fought. How much difference do you reckon 4 years has given Cruz as these two lock up in the center of the ring?
Are you kidding me? SoCal Crazy has been around since, I think, 2004. Maybe even sooner than that. This man has wrestled with legends. This man has toppled giants. The fact that Romeo Cruz wrestled him 4 years ago, that's nothing. SoCal Crazy, after battling cancer, coming back from the cusp of death, has been better, sharper, and quicker than I've ever seen him in years.
Well, now both men lock up the center of the ring, side headlock. Takes the arm from behind now, does Cruz, and now Crazy tries to counter it. He does very much, and now he's got him in his traps. But again comes Cruz with that side headlock. Now, these two really not giving an inch in these early moments, are they, Ronnie?
No, you can't. You cannot. You have to. If you're going to fight a veteran like SoCal Crazy, you have to be 100% in his face, coming at him 99% of the time. Because if you don't, guess what?
Now, here comes Crazy, just trying to take a moment now on the outside, trying to rejuvenate. But Cruz now talking that smack to the crowd, really getting him going.
I think Cruz is wasting time. If I were Cruz, I'd be out there. I'd be on top of SoCal Crazy. I'd be attacking him. I'd be hitting him with water bottles. I'd be hitting him with chairs. I'd be hitting him with people's shoes if I have to.
What wouldn't you hit him with?
I would hit him with everything. I'm telling you, nothing kills SoCal Crazy. The man is indestructible. I'm telling you.
He'll come back harder and stronger. This man has took everything on in life.
See?
And done it well. And now he's going to top over the top. And now he's trying to get that German suplex off, but it's a block.
See?
By Cruz. Sends him into the ropes, ducks underneath. Cruz again. Now leapfrogs over the top. Cruz again. Just dives over the top of him.
Look at that.
Big arm drag.
Look at that action. Look at that action. And now SoCal Crazy, he's feeling froggy. He's gonna leap, there he is! Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I wanna say SoCal Crazy may have hit his feet on that barricade. I don't know. Here it comes again, instant replay, baby. Now look, now watch his feet. Oh my God, yeah, his feet, it go right into the barricade. Let's see if that affects SoCal Crazy at all. And it definitely doesn't look or sound like it's affected SoCal Crazy at all. Oh. Romeo Cruz, you definitely don't want to trade shots like that with SoCal Crazy, I'm telling you, bud. Oh my goodness, another hard chop by SoCal Crazy. My God, you can hear that echoing here. Oh, Romeo Cruz takes the advantage by cutting off SoCal Crazy right as he gets in the ring. But that's what you gotta do. putting the boots to him, as it were. Wow, what a maneuver. Wow. Folks, I'm telling you, this action is so fast. If you blink, you're gonna miss it. Romeo Cruz definitely showing that 4 years of training has really paid off. Going for a pinfall there, but it's way too early, especially against a veteran like SoCal Crazy. You definitely don't want to do that. Romeo Cruz now throwing him in. Oh, big European uppercut. Going for a pinfall. Again, I think you gotta hit SoCal Crazy with something a lot bigger and badder than that. Crowd really coming alive here. But you know, I feel like the crowd is kind of torn between SoCal Crazy and Romeo Cruz. This is just a fantastic match. Kick to the chops. And SoCal Crazy, this could be where he turns the tables on Romeo Cruz. Referee starts the count. This could be a double count out. SoCal Crazy gets to his feet. Romeo gets to his feet. Big European uppercut. And SoCal Crazy answers back with a chop. Now we just have a back and forth brawl going between these two guys. Uh-oh. Yep, you made him mad, Romeo. Wow, a hair away. Looks like SoCal Crazy's asking for a quicker count. He thinks the ref was moving a little bit slow there. What's he pointing at? Oh, he's pointing at the turnbuckle. I thought he was gonna throw him into the fan over there in the corner. Oh, Romeo Cruz looks like he's got tangled up on the rope there, but I think he's got definitely some malicious thoughts. SoCal Crazy starts to fight back. Oh, SoCal Crazy misses the big dive. Oh no, this could spell doom for SoCal. Crowd's coming alive here for SoCal Crazy. Romeo Cruz, he seems to be getting distracted. Oh my God, what was that? Two. Oh my gosh. Another hair away from a three count. I don't even know what that move was, but boy, did it look like it hurt. SoCal Crazy definitely reeling in pain. Romeo Cruz is trying to capitalize. Let's see what he does. SoCal Crazy with a big backslide. Backslide fails into a big DDT. Wow. Folks, I'm telling you, this action tonight for Title Turmoil is hot. I'm telling you, it's not just the heat in California. This wrestling action is hot. I gotta tell you to get out here and check this out. You gotta see it live, folks. Big chop by SoCal Crazy. Uh-oh, they tangled up. SoCal Crazy. Uh-oh. Big tilt-a-whirl. SoCal Crazy going for a crossface, it looked like. Romeo Cruz. Oh my goodness, big Samoan drop by Romeo Cruz. Oh, wow. That would have been a huge feather in the cap of Romeo. SoCal Crazy trying to get these people to rally behind him. Romeo Cruz is just waiting for him. He's pointing at something. I don't know who he's pointing at. Uh-oh, he could be going for another Samoan drop. Wait a minute. Pinfall. And that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, SoCal Crazy!
Just now, and now he's trying to put Crazy away. Oh my, why'd you do it, Cruz? What was the point? Cruz has snapped. The crowd really against Cruz here. What is he doing? Why is he doing this after a stellar performance? He's really put Crazy in his place. Someone check on SoCal Crazy, because this was ridiculous. Poor sportsmanship from Romeo Cruz.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for SoCal Crazy!
After all that man has been through. Unbelievable from Romero Cruz.
Ladies and gentlemen, in 2 months, there will be a Rumble in Vista. Now here's the exciting part. We already have the first entrant. Let's take a look at the video.
Wow. What's up, dids and lady dids? I think introductions are in order. My name is Gnarly Charlie Gnar, and dids, you can look forward to seeing me at the Rumble in Vista October 14th at the Vista Boys and Girls Club. Dids, it's gonna be a ripper. I've been training, studying the ancient philosophies, and I believe it was Sun Tzu in The Art of War that said, Anakin, I have the high ground. And dids, Gnarly Charlie Gnar is keeping that high ground when I throw 19 other dids out of that ring. It's gonna be sweet, and I'll see you there, dude. Yeah.
All right, let's hear it for the first entrant, Gnarly Charlie, into the Rumble, baby. And you know, you folks gotta know, at SoCal Pro, you never know what's gonna happen. You never know who's gonna show up. And you never know what's gonna be said. For example, Daniel. Where's Daniel? Daniel! Someone get Daniel in here. Someone go get him. Daniel, get over here. And no, Daniel's not the second entrant into the Rumble. But, I believe Daniel has a birthday. Ah. Daniel, how long you been coming here, man?
Since day one.
Since day one, folks. Isn't that amazing? And how old are you gonna be?
44.
44! Wow! And how old were you when you first came?
26.
Sorry, I asked him math. Well, that's incredible, but you know what? You may be 44, but I think someone's got you beat. This man right here! Chuck, stand on up! Get on over here, Chuck. Chuck is, what are you, 88 today?
Yeah.
Chuck is 88 today, folks. That's incredible. Chuck, how long have you been coming to SoCal Pro matches?
Yeah, before day one.
Before day one. Wow, when he went, wow. So then you remember when I was wrestling.
Oh, yes.
That's a no. All right, everyone, here's what I want you to do for me right now. I want you all to stand up, and I want to sing these two dudes a happy birthday.
That's right. So it's me. Would. It's me. It's TNT, SoCal Pro Wrestling Hall of Famer, coming to you from my palatial estate here in beautiful Green Bay, Wisconsin. I've got a huge announcement for you folks tonight. You are in the presence of professional wrestling royalty. I'm not even talking about myself, and you know I'm not talking about those two pipsqueaks, Rick and Vic Dynamic. So sit your asses down over there at that announce table and show some respect. Tonight is the 87th birthday of my number one fan, the longest reigning pro wrestling fan in all of Southern California. I would like to ask Chuck to please stand. Be recognized by this audience for your incredible dedication to the sport of professional wrestling in California. Chuck, happy birthday, my good man. I only wish I could be there in person to celebrate with you, but I promise you, I will be there next month, September 9th, at Super Clash. As for right now, it's off to the pool party, baby.
All right, everybody, on the count of three, let's sing these two happy birthday. One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Daniel and Chuck. Happy birthday to you. Yes! Apparently Hulk Hogan has the same birthday as Chuck. All right, folks, we're going to take a brief intermission. So we'll see you in 15 minutes.
California. Saturday, August 12th, SoCal Pro Wrestling returns to the Vista Boys and Girls Club for title turmoil. The coveted SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship will be defended as the reigning champion Tommy Wilson defends against the Black Rose, Jew Diz. As a special stipulation to the match, the champion's manager Everett Scott will be handcuffed to the mighty Tortuga. The baddest man in SoCal Pro and reigning Golden State champion, Tanner Black, has issued an open challenge for his Golden State championship. Who will be the one to step up to this challenge and attempt to claim their place in history? All of this and more, including action from the neon phenomenon, Anthony Idol, the SoCal Pro Wrestling powerhouse, Matthias, Fidel, Bravo, and the high-flying legend, SoCal Crazy. Tickets are available now at SoCalProWrestling.com. Southern California. Saturday, August 12th, SoCal Pro Wrestling returns to the Vista Boys and Girls Club for title turmoil. The coveted SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship will be defended as the reigning champion Tommy Wilson defends against the Black Rose, Jew Diz. As a special stipulation to the match, the champion's manager Everett Scott will be handcuffed to the mighty Tortuga. The baddest man in SoCal Pro and reigning Golden State champion, Tanner Black, has issued an open challenge for his Golden State championship. Who will be the one to step up to this challenge and attempt to claim their place in history? All of this and more, including action from the neon phenomenon, Anthony Idol, the SoCal Pro Wrestling powerhouse, Matthias, Fidel, Bravo, and the high-flying legend, SoCal Crazy. Tickets are available now at SoCalProWrestling.com. California. Saturday, August 12th, SoCal Pro Wrestling returns to the Vista Boys and Girls Club for title turmoil. The coveted SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship will be defended as the reigning champion Tommy Wilson defends against the Black Rose, Jew Diz. As a special stipulation to the match, the champion's manager Everett Scott will be handcuffed to the mighty Tortuga. the baddest man in SoCal Pro and reigning Golden State Champion, Tanner Black, has issued an open challenge for his Golden State Championship. Who will be the one to step up to this challenge and attempt to claim their place in history? All of this and more, including action from the neon phenomenon, Anthony Idol, the SoCal Pro Wrestling powerhouse, Matthias, Fidel, Bravo, and the high-flying legend, SoCal Crazy. Tickets are available now at SoCalProWrestling.com. Southern California, Saturday, August 12th, SoCal Pro Wrestling returns to the Vista Boys and Girls Club for title turmoil. The coveted SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship will be defended as the reigning champion Tommy Wilson defends against the Black Rose, Jew Diz. As a special stipulation to the match, the champion's manager Everett Scott will be handcuffed to the mighty Tortuga. The baddest man in SoCal Pro and reigning Golden State Champion, Tanner Black, has issued an open challenge for his Golden State Championship. Who will be the one to step up to this challenge and attempt to claim their place in history? All of this and more, including action from the neon phenomenon, Anthony Idol, the SoCal Pro Wrestling powerhouse, Matthias, Fidel, Bravo, and the high-flying legend, SoCal Crazy. Tickets are available now at SoCalProWrestling.com. Southern California. Saturday, August 12th, SoCal Pro Wrestling returns to the Vista Boys and Girls Club for title turmoil. The coveted SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship will be defended as the reigning champion Tommy Wilson defends against the Black Rose, Jew Diz. As a special stipulation to the match, the champion's manager, Everett Scott, will be handcuffed to the mighty Tortuga. The baddest man in SoCal Pro and reigning Golden State champion, Tanner Black, has issued an open challenge for his Golden State championship. Who will be the one to step up to this challenge and attempt to claim their place in history? All of this and more, including action from the neon phenomenon, Anthony Idol, the SoCal Pro Wrestling powerhouse, Matthias, Fidel, Bravo, and the high-flying legend, SoCal Crazy. Tickets are available now at SoCalProWrestling.com.
Okay, the following contest is scheduled for one fall.
We are back here at SoCal Pro Wrestling for title turmoil. We have Braden Toon versus Fidel Bravo in what looks to be a hard-hitting contest.
Oh, man, if you know, I know this is your first time here at SoCal Pro, but the fact that you get to watch Fidel Bravo, you are in for a treat.
What can he offer us here tonight?
Fidel Bravo is going to use everything in his arsenal to beat Braden Toon. And, you know, a lot of the things that he does is very questionable, but he's also one of the greats here at SoCal Pro. So Enjoy.
Here comes Toon. Oh, now he's been locked up into the corner. Fidel now just moving slightly away.
I don't think Brayden Toon liked that. I've never heard of Brayden Toon, have you?
Nah, but he's really getting in his face here. Now both men circling the ring. Trying to keep an eye on them, locking up at the center of the ring. Side headlock here.
Side headlock from the side pony homie, baby.
Set into the corner. Big shoulder tackle once again. But even more by Toon.
Did you see that? The power of that man.
These two big men really showing what they've got here at SoCal Pro. And we've had some fantastic wrestling here tonight. Tanner Black taking on Rick Ellis in an absolutely excellent contest. Our opening match, Anthony Idol and Matthias, really good match.
Great match. And you know, you can't forget about SoCal Crazy versus Romeo Cruz. You know, and also you can't forget about the main event. Jew Diz taking on Tommy Wilson. And you know Jew Diz wants that belt back.
Well, mentioning before SoCal Crazy and Romeo Cruz with some high-flying offense, but it looks like Brayden Toon has got some of his own as he leaps to the outside, looks for a big knee, blocks. Fidel coming back with a big close up and a big knee by Brayden Toon.
Look at that big man move, jeez.
You give Kenny Omega a run for his money with that knee. Big elbow now by Toon.
Now listen to the crowd getting behind him.
Bravo looks rocked after a knee like that. And a big chop by Toon. I'll tell you what, after a chop like that, who hits harder? Anthony Idol or Brayden Toon?
Anthony Idol, 100%.
Tossed back into the ring now is Bravo, chased down by Toon. Looks for a pinfall. Hit one, two, two.
No way.
Tony Santana calling a two.
No way are you going to beat Fidel Bravo with just those fancy quick moves. No, no, no.
Stopped just in front of the referee. And Bravo with a backstabber. Big time backstabber by the man with an excellent handlebar stash. Man. One, two, and two.
That could have been it. That could have been it.
You look at the back of Brayden Toon's trunks, and it says unkillable. Is he living up to that nickname now?
You know, it doesn't look like he is, but, you know, when I was talking to him in the back, you know, the man literally looked at me with the most serious eyes, and he just said, unkillable. And that's all he said to me, and I was like, okay, let's see.
Well, but now here comes Bravo with a chop of his own and a big back elbow. Tells everyone to move out of the way. What's he going to do here? Oh, and another clubbing elbow by Fidel Bravo.
It looks like Bravo's definitely going to kill the unkillable tonight.
Looks for another pinfall, shoots it down, two, and no.
Wow, I thought that was it.
He's got that wild eye. Look at him, just Brayden Toon. Locked up now, center of the ring.
What would you call that move? That almost looks like a head crusher. That does not look like it feels good.
Does not look comfy at all. The crowd now really getting behind Toon. A couple of strikes to the chest. Of it quickly thrown down to the mat. Does Fidel Bravo.
Amazing, just amazing.
Really talking smack to the crowd now. Does Bravo and a big leg drop.
You know, for being someone who's first time here at SoCal Pro, Brayden Toon,
it seems
like the people really know him and are gravitating towards him.
They're really enjoying his big energy, but a big kick to the back of the head. That's got to be it, surely.
You know, I don't know. Like, maybe this man is unkillable.
But you see Bravo, he's talking smack to the crowd then going for the pinfall. Maybe that's a detriment to his game.
But, you know, Bravo has thrown almost everything at him. I don't know what else he can do, and Toon just keeps getting up.
Handlebar takedown now by Bravo. Referee's looking for maybe a stoppage here. I mean, that's a lot of pain to that right arm.
Yeah, but, you know, that's what you got to do. I'm telling you. You gotta start working on body parts, especially on these bigger dudes.
Step up enziguri by Toon. He looks to be coming back into this now. Duck the clothesline. Oh, double cross body. Both men down, center of the ring, and huge agonizing pain. Have you ever taken something like that before?
That was like two trucks colliding, jeez. You know, and you know, taking a move like that, that takes all the breath out of you.
All my people back home.
Look at these two.
These two are scrapping like two men in a Manchester pub on a Saturday night. They are absolutely rocking. Crowd firmly behind Braden Toon. Runs to the ropes. Toon now. Ducks underneath. Big kick to his gut. Kisses to the crowd. Big knee. Neckbreaker by Toon. Shoots for the cover now. One, two. Oh, he just gets a two count.
That was so quick. And for a big guy, I'm telling you, he moves like a cat.
He really loves this crowd, doesn't he? Does Braden Toon. What's he going to go for here? Big shooting star from the big man. Oh.
Wow. That was insane.
Have you ever seen somebody like that do a shooting star press?
I don't think so. No. No.
Unbelievable. But how has he not put Bravo away?
I'm telling you, Bravo is resilient. I'm telling you, you got to do more than just a couple of fancy moves to beat a vet like Fidel Bravo.
Look at this thing of beauty.
Jeez.
Unbelievable.
Fidel Bravo showing everyone what he thinks of him.
Not afraid to say what he thinks. Ducks underneath the clothesline. Big scraping DDT.
Wow.
He looks rocked as Toon. One, two. Oh,
wow,
big
I thought
power
that was it.
Kick out.
How was that not it?
Super kick to the back of the head.
How was that not it?
Let's see if this is. Kick to the back of the head. Two. And another kick out by Toon. Is he this unkillable?
You know how many times I've seen Fidel Bravo put someone away with the exact same set of moves?
He just looks so frustrated now, and Bravo pummeling away at Toon, screaming at the crowd and the referee. Toon now crawling towards the ropes, but Bravo will not let him. Trying to bring him back to his knees now. What does Bravo have in store?
Nothing good, I'll tell you that. Nothing good.
Looking for a suplex.
What's he gonna do? Uh-oh.
Ducked underneath the clothesline. Spinning back elbow.
Uh-oh.
And now is the unkillable gonna kill? With a beautiful. What is, one, two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Unkillable Braden Toon!
After that, I crack a seal. Then I go. Kids don't try that at home. I forgot how sober feel. Life been getting super real. Leave me alone, I'm in my zone. She do white like Home Alone. Molly smell like Delph. Am I too high? Yes. Perky make me itch. Crawling in my skin. Molly smell like Delph. Am I too high? Yes. Perky make me itch. Crawling in my skin.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, just a reminder, Saturday, September 9th, Super Clash, baby. You'll want to be here in Vista, so make sure y'all come out. How many of y'all coming to Super Clash? Yeah. You never know what's going to happen at SoCal Pro, so we'll definitely see you there. Are you ready for the main event?
Young brother from the cutter, always been a fighter, never been a runner. Mama was a hunter, daddy was a hunter, all my brothers hunt each other. Known a knuckle up and uppercut, a slugger, punch a snuffer, stunner, thugger, gunner, stutter, stutter, blutter, sputter. You gon' do the Brooklyn brucker, pucker, kind of drummer. Father thought I was a parasite in mama belly, but he had it wrong. He ain't know he had a spawn of a warlord till in 9 months I was born. Big black strong body, your LeBron. I'm a big king, killing all the pawn. Better be informed when I blow the horn. Bringing in the dust, waking up the dawn, looking at the card. Prophesized by the shaman voodoo. Seen it all through the eye of Horus that I watch and view through. There was other warriors before me, but they not this brutal. All this money, but I'm not Mobutu. You don't know me, you forgot, now you do. Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu. My name is Shaka Zulu. I'm at the top of Khufu. I got the power, who knew? What would a god salute you? They call me Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu.
Gentlemen, are you ready for the main event of Title Turmoil? Ladies and gentlemen, Everett Scott will now be handcuffed to the mighty Tortuga! Have a lock. Ladies and gentlemen, may I introduce the challenger from San Francisco, California. He is the Black Rose, Jew Dave! And the champion. He hails from San Diego, California. He is the reigning SoCal Pro Heavyweight Champion, Tommy Wilson!
Welcome to our main event here at SoCal Pro Wrestling. And now, just at the beginning of the match, Tommy Wilson has just blindsided Judas.
You know, I think Tommy Wilson is definitely gonna set a precedent tonight. Well, he's definitely gonna send a message, and the message is, don't mess with me. I mean, the man is the Thundermaker. The Thundermaker is his new surname.
Well, he's definitely going to try and bring the thunder to Judas here today with a sidekick and now a chop straight to the challenger and again straight on the offense on Judas. He hasn't let up. Now, Evelyn Scott and Tortuga are handcuffed outside of the ring. That
yes.
prevents Evelyn Scott from getting involved in this match, surely.
Yes, yes, and you know, you got to know, Everett Scott is going to try every weaselly way he can to get away from Tortuga and help Tommy Wilson get that win tonight.
Well, Ronnie, let me ask you this. How many times have you been handcuffed to somebody wearing a mask on a Saturday night?
Actually, one time. I can honestly say one time. It was not my favorite, and it ended very, very wrong.
Judas now with a side elbow. Step up in Zaguri on the champion, the challenger now. This is for the SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship. As Judas with a diving crossbody, early cover, two, and referee Chuck Finley counts the two.
And you know, Judas, I believe he is the longest reigning SoCal Pro Heavyweight Champion here at SoCal Pro. He's the longest. Now, you gotta know that holding that title is no easy feat. And the fact that he's held it, I don't remember how many months the man held it, but it was a long time. It was impressive.
Irish whip into the corner. Wilson sent to the outside.
Tommy looks like a tumbleweed.
Tortuga is preventing Everett Scott from giving advice to his man. How much is that going to make a difference for Tommy Wilson in this championship match?
Oh, a huge difference. I mean, Everett Scott is he's definitely the factor, the winning formula for Tommy Wilson. And I mean, the man has literally, you know, brought so many wrestlers into the championship spotlight. And, you know, Tommy Wilson is no different. Now, Tommy Wilson is a seasoned vet, but with Everett Scott behind him, it's definitely a deadly combination.
Judas sent to the outside now. Wilson stalking his prey, just using those mind games, like he said earlier in the broadcast. He topped the broadcast off by saying that he will defeat Judas for a third time.
Yes.
What kind of effect will that have on our challenger tonight?
I mean, you know, that's the thing about Judas, is he doesn't let anything bother him. Judas just comes out and he does. And, you know, I've seen this man get beat, literally beat to a pulp, and he will still find a way to come out on top. It's incredible.
Judas sent into the barricade right in front of Mona, cheering him on at ringside.
That's right, Miss Mona. You don't want to get too close to Miss Mona if you're Tommy Wilson.
Suplex now.
Wow.
And beautiful roll through there by Wilson following the suplex, but just a one count. Judas getting out really quickly, and now a side headlock, trying to take the wind out of the sails of our challenger tonight. We are here at Chula Vista. Here for SoCal Pro title turmoil. This is for the SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship, the prestigious heavyweight championship. And now Jude Diz trying to get back into this match. A couple of side shots, ducks underneath the clothesline, and a big spinning heel kick from the champion every time. Two,
just a two count. Every time that Judiz tries to find a way back into this match, Tommy Wilson is just there to cut him off.
You know, it's funny you said Chula Vista. You need to get your geography right, correct, man. You know, we're in Vista, California, baby. Chula Vista is way south.
That is me as a Brit not knowing my American geography.
That's right, and I know you guys like to drive that little tiny car.
We only go 20 miles up the road and we're in somewhere else. Judiz now sent into the post, but he's blocked, and he sends Wilson instead.
Tommy goes into the post.
Judiz blocking his opponent now, and he's trying to get back into this match. Wilson has found a way to keep him from getting momentum, but it looks like Judiz is finally starting to gain that momentum. Oh, and he saw the kick coming.
And he, you know, that was smart. He saw the kick coming because that's Tommy Wilson's finishing move, the super kick. Judiz knows all too well that once he gets hit with that, it's over.
It's lights out once you face that super kick. One of the deadliest moves in professional wrestling. Judiz now making his way back in the ring. Both men trying to lock up.
Measuring each other out now. You know, you kind of don't want to measure out with Tommy Wilson, because Tommy Wilson, he's like three moves ahead of you every time.
Double roll through now. Big strike though from Judiz. The challenger now backs him off against the ropes. And a big back body drop.
Huge back body drop. Did you see the elevation?
But he's now thrown into the ropes every single time. There is no momentum for Judiz to get back into this. The champion using his smarts and a front base drop kick, sending the challenger to the outside.
But that's what you gotta do. You gotta stay on top of Judiz, because again, if you let the man get his wind, that's when he's really troublesome. So Tommy Wilson is doing what Tommy Wilson does best. Referee. And that's literally run the gas right out of you.
Referee at a count of six now. Tommy now looking maybe for a count out, but he's trying to drag Judiz out of the ring. Was that a smart move, or would you have left him out of the ring?
You know, he's the champion. Remember, if Judiz gets counted out, Tommy still wins the belt. You know, even if Tommy gets counted out, he still keeps the belt. At this point, if I were Tommy, I would just focus on surviving Judiz's assault.
That's right, champion's advantage here for the SoCal Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. Front face lock takeover now, and a side headlock again, trying to slow down the pace of the challenger, and now the legs wrapped round. It's like a sleeper hold on our challenger. He's asking the referee to see if Judiz wants to continue.
And again, that's what he does. He gasses you out.
Slowly fading now is the challenger. Now, Ronnie, what does it take to make someone like Judiz pass out? Because it doesn't look like a sleeper hold really put him down.
You know, that's the thing. The resilience of Judiz is at the next level. And can you knock out Judiz? I don't think you can. The man literally finds a way. And you know, I think Tommy Wilson knows that. So Tommy Wilson is trying to stay on top of him as much as he can. You know, obviously without getting two boots to the face for his troubles.
Exactly. Beautiful basement drop kick now. Maybe looking for some kind of hold. Dropped into the second turnbuckle goes Judiz.
It's not good.
Tommy now stalking the challenger, looking for a neck breaker.
Big neck breaker. Crushing neck breaker. Listen to the crowd. Listen to it.
Crowd firmly behind the challenger, but the champion seems unfazed.
Oh, no. He's just stepping on the man's hair.
Referee Chuck Finley telling him to just let it go, but he's pulling on the hair.
Now that is an underhanded, dirty move. And you know, I'd be lying if I said I never did that.
I'm gonna say, you gotta respect something like that from our Rotten Ronnie.
Oh yeah.
Brutal honesty. Now, challenger pushed into the corner, thrown by the hair.
He threw him right by his dreads.
I mean, the hair has played a huge disadvantage for the challenger so far, and a big leg drop by the champion. One, two, and no.
That's right. What's Everett Scott doing? What's he doing over there? It looks like he's behaving. He's yelling at some of the crowd, but
talking smack as usual.
It looks like he's actually behaving. Now, is he up to something? Who knows?
Side Russian leg sweep by the champion. Uh-oh. And transitioning into a submission hold. Will the challenger quit?
That move hurts because, you can't breathe in that move.
A move like this reminds me of another famous British wrestler, Zack Sabre Jr., an absolutely stupendous submission specialist. And Tommy Wilson is looking to try and emulate that with a great submission hold of his own. But the challenger has formed a pinfall, and it's a two count.
Man, I thought he had him. You know how much of an upset that would be if Drew Diz beat Tommy Wilson after last month being here? Anthony Idol beat Tommy Wilson? That would be tragic for Tommy.
Tommy now with a knee to the side of the face. Referee up to a three count, and Wilson will let go. He could have caused a disqualification and still took the championship home.
Did you see what he did? He just spit on Tortuga.
Tortuga looks extremely ticked off.
Uh-oh.
But he can't do anything about it because that will cost you Diz the championship. Maybe that is the game plan, but we don't know because Everett Scott can't get involved.
And that's true. If Tortuga lays a hand on Everett Scott, that could blow it for Drew Diz winning the title. You're absolutely right.
Wilson now moves away from the champion, from the challenger. Looking for something now. What is going through the mind of the champion?
Nothing good. Nothing good is going through that man's mind. He's thinking, oh man.
Double clothesline by both men, center of the ring.
But Tommy Wilson is thinking about nothing except, how do I hurt Drew Diz? How do I end this match as fast as possible? And that's exactly what he's doing. He might be playing possum here. I wouldn't be surprised.
Both men trying to keep going here in this championship match. This is for the SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship here in Vista, California.
Yes.
So you got it right this time.
Your geography is correct, sir.
Now Wilson now. Goes for the body drop again. Drew Diz now over the top.
Oh,
big knee to the side of the face. That has the champion rocked. Oh, the side slam.
He's setting him up.
One, two, and nearly 2¾ from the referee.
Drew Diz was setting him up, man. I'm telling you, Drew Diz is planning his big finish.
Crowd are loving this matchup in our main event.
Wait a minute.
He's counting.
Wait
again.
A minute.
One, two, no. Go on the ropes. And the referee noticed. Brilliant officiating by Chuck Finley.
I thought for sure
that was. One, two.
Oh, I thought, wait.
Looks like he's going for some sort of Boston crab, maybe.
I think he's going for the Boston.
Both hands on the rope, though the referee has to call the submission off.
No!
Wait a minute!
Oh,
big powerbomb! One, two, two and a half from the challenger. He nearly put Tommy Wilson away.
I cannot believe it. He was trying to go for his Boston Crab, and he turned it into a sit-out powerbomb.
Unbelievable.
Goodness.
We have had an incredible night of wrestling here at SoCal Pro Wrestling. Please, whatever you do, please give some love to all of our wrestlers tonight by going to our Instagram, that is SoCalPro on Instagram, and sending some love to our wrestlers.
Yes, absolutely. Get on over there, folks.
Both men now top of the rope. Drew Diz now. Looks like he's going for a sunset flip powerbomb. One, two, and just a two count, but brilliant sunset flip from the challenger.
A hair away from beating Tommy Wilson.
Drew Diz now. Taken down by the champion, maybe looking for a figure four leg lock. Made famous.
Oh no.
By the brilliant and GOAT Ric Flair.
Yeah,
we know how devastating this move is, but now Drew Diz maybe trying to get to the ropes, or he could try and flip Wilson to reverse the pressure, but we don't know because that is excruciating pain.
Yes, and this move hurts so much. You don't know the pressure that goes onto your knee. Just, you're in this move for a second, And already you just want to scream.
Even if Judiz gets somehow manages to break this hold, that's going to take a real toll on his knee, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely.
Wilson now. Oh, looks like he snapped his hand. Trying to prevent the counter. Judiz now.
Oh, he has to do it. He grabs the rope.
He's got it. Referee Chuck Finley now having to break the count. But he held on as long as he could to add extra pain.
Man, you know, Judiz might be in trouble.
And now Wilson.
Oh, he's feeling it.
He's tuning up the band.
Oh, he's feeling it.
Shades of the great Shawn Michaels by tuning up the band. He's looking for that super kick to put his lights out.
Oh, no.
Wilson, the champion, stalking the challenger. He moves to the other side of the ring, out of his view.
Oh, no.
He goes for it.
Wait.
Blocked by the challenger. Judiz now looking for the knee. Super kick.
Oh, no.
Now Wilson looking for a reverse on Priya, maybe. Judiz now.
Wait a minute.
Gut wrench.
Oh, there
gut
it is.
Gut wrench knee. But wise of the champion to fall to the outside.
Yes.
He can't lose the championship there.
No, he cannot. And that was a very smart move of Tommy Wilson. Again, being the veteran in this match, he rolled right out of the ring because he knew he was in trouble. He knew he got hit by that knee, but also look at Judiz. He's still feeling the knee effects from that figure four leg lock. Smart move by Tommy Wilson.
As we see again on our instant replay, look at that knee to the face.
My God.
If Wilson had landed in the ring, do you reckon that could have been a three count?
That could have been the three count, 100%.
Wilson now making his way back up onto the apron. Ducks underneath the challenger and looks to be walking away.
See, he's smart. See, he's saying to heck with it, and that's...
Oh, my days. That's it. Tommy Wilson has taken a count out loss, which means Judiz wins the contest, but the championship will remain on the champion, Tommy Wilson. Unbelievable.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner by countout, Judiz. Again, since there was a countout, the title does not change hands.
Young brother from the cutter, always been a fighter, never been a runner. Woo. Mama was a hunter, daddy was a hunter, all my brothers hunt each other. Known a knuckle up and uppercutter, slugger, puncher, snuffer, stunner, thugger, gunner, stutter, blutter, sputter, you gon' do the Brooklyn pucker, pucker.
Wait a second! Anthony Idol's back! And now both men scrap it outside the ring! Idol throws Wilson back into the ring, and he's taken several shots, but Matthias is back. The man who Everett Scott cost in the early moments is back. It's chaos here at SoCal Pro Wrestling. Matthias now takes Idol into the corner, lobbing blows. This is sick. It looks like an unholy alliance has been made between Wilson and Matthias. This is disgraceful. Tortuga now into the ring, trying to even the odds. Clubbing blows to Matthias. But the champion seems to have rocked Tortuga in a super kick. Wait a minute! SoCal Crazy's here, trying to even up the odds. Now here's Crazy, beautiful Hurricane Rana. And now Romero Cruz is here. What is going on? Everything is falling down. The referee's calling for somebody. I don't know who. Security are now making their way down to the ring, trying to break this up. It's chaos and pandemonium here. You can ring the damn bell all you want, but nothing is going to stop these men from absolutely tearing each other apart. Thank you for tuning in to Title Turmoil here at SoCal Pro Wrestling. We have seen some incredible scenes tonight, but this is now going down like a pub on a Saturday night back home in England. This is unbelievable scenes here in Vista, California. Security being thrown apart, everybody standing. Unbelievable. Even the referees are getting it. Anyone can get it in that ring tonight. Oh no. You gotta feel sorry for that man. He's in the with four absolute maniacs. Oh! Shot to the outside. Unbelievable from Anthony Idol.
You, paper champion. You, busted machine. You, little Romeo. And you, most of all, you bloated little toad. You want to run these little games? You want to get down? Well, I'll tell you what. I'll see you right back here in September. For War Games!
War Games? Unbelievable!
That's right, bring your squad, and I'm gonna bring mine, and we can get down! War Games! You're on! Evan, grab my belt!
I was a parasite in mama belly, but he had it wrong. He ain't know he had a spawn of a warlord. Till in 9 months I was born. Big black strong body, your LeBron. I'm a big king, killing all the pawn. Better be informed when I blow the horn. Bringing in the dust, waking up the dawn. Looking at the card. Prophesized by the shaman.
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard it live. September War Games live in a steel cage match, baby!
Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu. My name is Shaka Zulu. I'm at the top of Khufu. I got the power, who knew? Why would a god salute you? They call me Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu. My name is Shaka Zulu. I'm at the top of Khufu. I got the power, who knew? Why would a god salute you? God. I'm a lion when he growl. I'm a tiger on the prowl. Call a firefighter, I got fire in my bowels.
Hey, real quick, everybody here, real quick. Real quick. I have now been back in wrestling for a few months now. And I'm still receiving a lot of email, a lot of DMs, a lot of messages from you guys wishing me the best. So thank you again. Are you guys ready for September? Are you guys ready? Are you ready for Tortuga's first War Game? Are you guys ready for G-Diz, his first War Game? And big man, this isn't our first War Games. This isn't our first one. And you damn better believe it ain't gonna be our last one.
Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu, Shaka Zulu. My name is Shaka Zulu.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us at Tidal Turmoil. We will see you all next month for War Games.